The last thing with our average fasteners is the bolts, and there are a bunch of different types of bolts. The ones that we use most often in the shop are called hex bolts. They're called hex bolts because they have a hexagon-shaped head. That's the average shape for a bolt head. The other types that you're going to run into are carriage bolts, and those have a rounded head on the top. And then just below the head, before you get to the round shaft, there's a slight squared notch just below the head of the bolt. Then you have your shaft and your threaded bits that your nuts fasten onto. But what those allow you to do is the square will actually hold onto the material that you put it into. So if you put it in wood, they have these little washers that you can actually hammer into the wood so that you've got a piece of metal that keeps it from turning. But in theater, we usually just hammer that into the wood, and the squared off keeps it from spinning in the wood so that you don't have to have anything to hold onto the round head of the bolt. And then you just tighten the nut onto the threads on the other side. Another one that you're going to run into is a lag screw. It's actually a screw. I don't classify it as a bolt, but it's skirting the line between screw and bolt. The reason that it's a screw is because the threads are the same cut as a screw. It also has a point to it. So it's meant for actually drilling its own hole for fastening, which regular bolts are not. Regular bolts, you have to pre-drill the hole so that you've got an opening for the bolt to slide through, and then you tighten it down, and that's where it gets its fasten strength from. A lag is when you need something stronger than a screw. So it's the thickness of a bolt body, but you can't get to the other side of the bolt to tighten it down. So the screw design gets married to the bolt design, and we end with a lag screw or a lag bolt, depending on who you are, who you're talking to. You've also got a few different types of other bolts that you can run into, but carriage bolts and hex bolts are going to be the ones that you're going to run into normally in the shop. And then you've also got the lag screw, lag bolt that you'll run into if you're attaching into a floor, usually. On top of the bolts, what you're going to want to use are washers and nuts. A washer is a flat, round piece of steel that has a hole drilled into it the size of the bolt that you're using it on, and it is used to distribute the load across a larger area in order to increase its grip strength and also to cause less damage to the material that you're bolting it to. Wood is soft, so if you over-tighten it, what can happen is the head of the bolt or the nut, as you tighten, can sink into the wood itself, and then it makes it very difficult to loosen and take out later. By using the washer, it distributes that load, so as you're tightening, you can sink into the material a little bit, but you don't sink as far, and you have a little bit of space around that bolt head or nut to grip an object around, a pair of needle nose pliers or a wrench around to get it out. That takes us into the nut. There are several different types of nuts. The standard type of nut has a regular thread into it and it has a hex shape so that it can be grabbed with the wrenches and pliers. You can also have an acorn nut, which has a rounded top and it is enclosed on the end so that you don't have a bolt head or the end of a bolt sticking out past the nut like you do with a standard nut. Another type that you're going to run into often in theater is called the lock nut or the nylock nut. The nylocks have a ring of plastic nylon on the end, so you'll see a slight round edge past the hex on a lock nut, and that is what houses that plastic disc. That plastic ring puts pressure on the bolt threads after it's been threaded through the nut part to keep it from wiggling off. With a regular nut, if there's enough vibrations on the bolt, it can actually loosen the nut. The vibrations cause a natural rotation in the bolt, and it can loosen the nut over time. So to keep that from happening, you use a nylock or a lock nut, and that nylon plastic disc keeps the nut from vibrating off of the bolt. Also, to do that, if you don't have access to the nylocks or you can't afford the nylocks, a cheaper option is called a split washer or a lock washer. It is a washer that is cut on one side and slightly split, so that the ends don't match up, so that as you tighten the nut around the bolt, the pressure from that split washer keeps a slight pressure on the nut to keep the vibrations from loosening. With large enough vibrations, it can still loosen, so it's less reliable than a nylock, but it is a good solution if you need to cut down on cost or you've got a lot to buy from, and it doesn't go through a lot of movement, just a little bit. All right, so moving on from nuts, there's obviously, you can see in this image here, there's a lot of other nuts and bolts that you can find out there, but hex bolts, carriage bolts, and lag screws are going to be the types of bolts that you're going to run into. And then we use hex nuts, nylocks. Occasionally we'll use an acorn nut or a wing nut, which is a nut that has the little wings going off, so you don't have to have a tool. You can actually tighten or loosen it by hand. And then washers and lock washers. Those are the bolts and those types of fasteners that we'll use.